Tonight on Five Rounds, it's a special UFC Fight Night Machida versus Dollaway edition. As the surging CB Dollaway has the opportunity of a lifetime, he'll have to do it in the most hostile mixed martial arts territory there is. And he'll have to do it against one of the most dominating fighters in the UFC, Lyoto Machida, who is also looking to get back on track with an impressive win. Plus, Canadian Mitch Gagnon joins us in studio as he prepares to take on the redemption-seeking former bantamweight champion Henan Barão in the co-main event. And Robin Black showcases the impressive submission game of the Northern Strangler in this week's breakdown. We've got all that and more in the special edition of Five Rounds, and it starts right now. This is Five Rounds. Welcome to our FN studios. I am John Ramdean, alongside my good friend, Mr. Robin Black, and the UFC returns to the birthplace of the Gracies this weekend. The main event, former 205-pound champion Lyoto the Dragon Machida taking on Ultimate Fighter alum CB Dollaway in a 185-pound battle. And I will tell you, Robin, right off the hop, I think this is a one-sided beating. I think Lyoto Machida has his way with CB Dollaway. It is a huge step up in competition for the wrestler, but you're really high on CB Dollaway.
Well, he's looked great. I mean, his striking is crisper than it's ever been. His wrestling's always been good. He's in phenomenal shape, and he's been performing at a high level. So can he handle a Lyoto Machida? Sure, on his very best night, if he comes prepared, if he catches Machida early, it's all kinds of ways that he can get himself in this fight. But you've got all of that in front of you, and Brazil, the main event, you know, under pressure. The pressure of it alone is tough for some guy to deal with, and he is definitely not at the level of Machida. At least he hasn't been so far through his career. So he needs the very best night under the very worst circumstances. That's a tough order.
Right now, 4-1 in his previous five. However, that loss comes against the biggest name opponent in Tim Boach. And I know there's many people out there believe that CB Dollaway was robbed in that fight and that the nod should have gone to him. But we see Jason Miller not mentally there. Yeah. Obviously, during that time, dealing with a bunch of issues. Daniel Sarapian down at 170 pounds. Francis Carmont no longer with the Ultimate Fighting Championship. So this is a huge task for CB Dollaway.
Yeah, and that's the thing. You look great. You move well. You know, your skills look always improving, all of those things. And then you go and you face a guy like Lyoto Machida. Lyoto Machida just lost to Weidman in the Fight of the Year. Definitely on most people's list,
my
Fight of the Year. Amazing performance, amazing fight. Came back in round five and looked phenomenal in round five. Took all kinds of abuse. Lyoto Machida's the real deal. You know, CB, Clarence Byron, man, you need to have the best night you've ever had in your life. Is he capable of it? Sure he is, but this is a tough assignment in Brazil.
CB Dollaway's teammate Ryan Bader faced off with Lyoto Machida, and we all know what you're not supposed to do against Lyoto Machida, and that is chase him, but he tricks people. He sets traps and forces his opponents to chase after him where he can use his counter-striking abilities. Do you see CB Dollaway being more disciplined and reeling himself in if Machida sets those type of traps?
Yeah, I am trying to find arguments for you to say Dollaway's in this fight. I'm trying to find them for all of us so we can watch this fight and go, well, it could go either way. And while we're looking that deep for it, there's one difference that is there that was not there when his teammate Ryan Bader fought him, and that is that Chris Weidman just showed a pretty good blueprint of how you can fight him.
That's Chris Weidman.
I know, right? Kick with the kicker. Try to kick with him, so don't be afraid, because he's not trying to take you down. If you're going to kick with him at range and he doesn't kick for fear of the takedown, you can try to take over that kicking range. Stay mobile. Don't charge your way in. Cut the cage off. Weidman showed you how to do it. But you're right. That's Chris Weidman.
In the co-featured bout, the Canadian Mitch Gagnon in easily his biggest test to date as he takes on the former 135-pound champion, Henan Barão. I mean, this guy is ridiculous. Wins over Eddie Wineland, Michael McDonald, Uriah Faber. He is legit. He believes that, you know, when he was caught by TJ Dillashaw, he just couldn't recover from the trauma, and that allowed TJ Dillashaw to control the rest of the fight. He's in Brazil, and he's coming after Mitch Gagnon.
Yeah, Henan Barão is at a big turning point here, and the thing with a turning point is all of the importance of it can really drive you to have the best performance you've had, but it can also kind of crush you under some pressure. So how is Henan Barão going to process that? He's coming off not only a loss, but then, you know, maybe, I don't know if it's an embarrassment for him or what it was, but a failure to even get into that fight because he fell while cutting weight. So there's the pressures of the weight cut, the pressures of coming off your first loss in your whole life, basically, and then having to come back in Brazil against a young guy. And so there's a lot of pressure on Barão for sure.
But at the same time, you have to expect that for Henan Barão, this is a guy that was called one of the pound-for-pound best only a year ago, less than a year ago, and now he has something to prove, so there's no way he can mess around. Like you said, didn't get to compete in that last fight against TJ Dillashaw and had his title taken away from him. He has something to prove here.
Yes, he certainly does. And you know, one thing we're lucky to do is we have Mitch Gagnon here in Ontario. When you're facing a guy, when you have a fight this important against one of the pound-for-pound greats in the world, we get the opportunity to teach you a little bit about him. He's going to come up and be in studio. And also, I wanted to go in and break down Mitch Gagnon a little bit so I could introduce you guys a little bit to what to expect from a guy that I'm calling the Northern Strangler in this week's breakdown.
And that's what it comes down to, Robin, the mental strength of Mitch Gagnon. He's going to try his best to make it a physical encounter. What are some of the things that he needs to avoid from Henan Barão and to ensure his success?
It's an interesting thing because Henan Barão, what he does extremely well. But you know what you're getting. He's got a beautiful left hand and right low kick. On the mat, he is super, super fast. But Mitch is very good on the ground as well. So really, the question mark is which Henan Barão shows up. The best Henan Barão we've ever seen or a Henan Barão who feels a little bit of the pressure because Mitch is not going to stop going forward. He's the right guy to get an assignment like this, and it's going to be interesting to talk to him about it because this is a tough test.
We also got to quickly talk about Eric Silva, who makes his return to the UFC, taking on Mike Rhodes. And for my money, I love watching Eric Silva fight. The guy comes to entertain. He's always flashy, and that sometimes leads to his downfall. If he just goes back to the drawing board and tightens up those abilities and minimize the risk, where do you see him in the welterweight division? Is this a guy that could get into the top five?
Yeah, the last thing to develop in a lot of high, explosive athletes' careers is often defense. And this guy's been building on that, so that's something to watch for in this fight.
Straight ahead, there he is, Mitch Gagnon. He'll join us on set to talk about his upcoming fight as soon as he's done giving John Pollock an autograph when Five Rounds on FN continues.